on neoclassical growth theory. Okay, it designed to show how growth in capital stock, growth in labor force, or advancement in technology, okay, affect your growth in output. Okay, growth in output, when I am saying, so if you remember, we define economic growth in terms of expansion of output. Okay, and I talk about two way. We define output expansion two way. One is in extensive form, where the total output is increasing. Second is in intensive form, okay, where you take per capita output. Okay, so when your total output is increasing, okay, so we will not be sure whether it is beneficial for the population of the country or not. Okay, why? Suppose your output is growing at certain percentage, but population is growing much faster. Okay, then per person output, okay, will be much lower. So it is better to look at output per person, which is population. And in the modern that we are considering, the entire population is working, so output per worker. Okay, so Sono has looked at intensive growth aspect. Okay, so expansion of output we've been considering in intensive form. Okay, in this way we can know that if output per worker is growing, the standard of living of the people of the country is improving. Okay, so in this way we have simplified. Later on, I've been in absolute sense also, as well as in your relative sense also. Okay, in both way I will depict the thing. Okay, it is a simple derivation. You people will be able to associate. Otherwise, generally what happens is student not able to associate what is happening. And this I have written in discrete form. Okay, it should be dk by dt into 1 by k. Similarly for labor and capital. Okay, so growth theory we will look in continuous time. Okay, so sometimes they ask in the examination also. So in growth theory, which time period is better, discrete time period or continuous time period? So we are looking at a continuous expansion in output over a longer period of time. Okay, so we are considering continuous time period. Okay, this derivation part I will do later when I am going to discuss about agent of growth. Okay, so Sono model is designed to show how growth in capital stock, growth in labor force, and your improvement in technology is going to affect your growth in output. Okay, so you people have done supply and demand side. Okay, so just like any economic model, okay, in the Sono model, equilibrium is determined by the interaction of demand and supply. Okay, so introduction, everybody, you will remember what is introduction you have to write. So every time when you are writing the Sono model, okay, you have to start with Sono model on neoclassical growth theory developed by Sono and Swan. It designed to show how growth in capital stock, growth in labor force, and advancement in technology is going to affect the growth in output. Okay, and that will determine my growth rate in labor. Sono has assumed intensive growth form. Okay, Sono has taken, you can say Sono has taken intensive growth form, where he has considered per capita terms in defining every variable. Okay, that will be your starting point. Then you will like supply and demand. Notes will be available in the website. Unlike any economic model, okay, equilibrium, if you remember, it is determined by the demand and supply. So in the Sono model, equilibrium will be determined by the equality of demand and supply. Okay, so first I will look at the supply of goods and production function. So supply of goods is determined by the production function. If you remember, we have done the production function in the previous lecture. So first I will look at the supply side. Supply of goods is determined by production function. Okay, and if you remember, okay, production function gives me technical relationship between input and output. How much output I can be produced, I will be knowing from my production function. Okay, is it clear? This part, supply of goods in the Sono model is based on production function. What happened to everyone? I told everyone to join on time. I told everyone to join on time. Okay, if you miss the introduction part, it will be difficult to carry on in the class. Okay, try to be 5 minutes before the start of the lecture. Okay, so what I am doing, I am repeating again those who have joined. So we are doing Swan model introductory part. Okay. So growth in Swan model determined by your accumulation of capital stock, growth in labor cost, and your advancement in technology. Okay. Given this setup, you people know that in equilibrium, in a simple framework that you know, demand and supply determine equilibrium. Interaction of demand and supply determine equilibrium. So in the Swan model also, supply and demand, okay, aspect we will consider to determine the equilibrium. Okay. Or a steady state growth path you can say. Net over. Okay. When we introduce the growth rate of capital stock. Okay. So right now I'm discussing growth of goods. Okay. Supply of goods. Okay. So supply of goods is based upon production function. And production function is a function of capital and labor. Okay. Where Y is your total output. Okay. K is your capital stock and N is your labor cost. Okay. So now assume that production function is homogeneous of the given. This production function is homogeneous of the given. Right in full, homogeneous of the given. That means this production function exhibit constant return to scale. Right? Yesterday we have done homogeneous of the given. So now assume that production function is homogeneous of degree 1, okay? That means the production function exhibits See, I am repeating one more time, okay? If people have started to join everyone, most of you, okay? Yeah. Net, okay? So every time if you join net, it is no use of doing the lecture, okay? You will miss the important part, then it will be difficult to understand the thing, okay? So remember what we are doing. 12 p.m. your class start, you should be available by 11:55 a.m. Okay? So this is your production function. Okay? So now assume that production function is homogeneous of degree 1. Okay? So this function exhibits constant return to scale. And by definition, what constant return to scale means? If you double the input, output also double. Right? So I double the input by lambda, output being double, right? I double the input by lambda, my output increases by lambda. What is this term? This term is y, okay? So I can write a lambda y, okay? Net lambda equal to 1 by n, okay? This is important part of the derivation, okay? This everyone have to remember. Okay. Okay. So I substitute this value of lambda inside here. Okay, just look at it, what is happening. K by N, this will be 1. Lambda is 1 by N, so it will be Y by N. This is what capital per worker, right? So my K by N is capital per worker. I denote by small k. Remember how to write this, okay? Many time students just write this, okay? This is capital K, small k write like this. And this is the term we are going to use throughout Swan model. Okay? Write small k like this. This is capital per worker. Y by N, capital Y, I write small y. Make it right like this. Okay? This is my output per worker. This is my output per worker. Okay? So I writing my production function in terms of per worker term. Okay? If you remember, what is this? This is showing you a standard of living also. Productivity of neighbor also, okay, same thing. So I am writing this in small f to denote that we are taking per worker term, okay. So capital per worker, okay, equal to your output per worker. So I have written the production function, okay, in terms of capital per worker terms, or you can write in this way. Output per worker is a function of capital per worker, small k. Everything I have converted into per worker term, and the reason being, Sono has considered intensive form of growth. Okay, it is a better way to understand whether the country is progressing or not, or whether there is an improvement in standard of living or not. Okay, this part is clear. So from supply side, we have output per worker equal is a function of capital per worker. Okay, and how we will draw the graph? Anyone remember the graph? Here I will take output per worker. Previously I am taking total product output. Here I will take capital per worker. Okay, let me extend this one. This is capital per worker. This is output per worker. Okay, and it will be like this. Okay, this is a production function. Okay, y is a function of output per worker, is a function of capital per worker. Okay, what will be f prime k? What will be this term? Positive, negative? Take the snow. What it is? Positive? We have done yesterday, right? Okay. So marginal product. This is what? Marginal product of capital per worker is positive. Okay. So given the capital stock, if you are increasing labor, okay, what will happen? Marginal product of capital per worker will remain positive, but it will decline. In the yesterday example, your first unit of labor is adding 6 unit of output given the capital stock. Second unit of labor is adding 5 unit of output. Okay, so as I increase the labor given the capital stock, what is happening? It is declining. Marginal product of capital per worker is declining. So f double prime k will be negative. Okay, marginal product of capital per worker is positive. Okay, as I keep increasing one factor, keeping other constant, okay, it will be declining. Okay, it will add positively to the output. It add positively to the output, but at decreasing rate. Is it clear? This is important. If this is not clear, then ask me again and again. Well, I am going to use only this term in the home Swanow model. Any doubt anyone have, then they can raise now. Okay, so I can move. This part is clear, right? Okay. So here on the side you write it out. Okay, f prime k is positive in the examination. Okay, when they ask you to discuss something, you write this thing. Okay, so you will be getting full marks. F double prime k is less than 0, and many times we forget the interpretation. Okay, this is marginal product of capital per worker. Write it out. Marginal product of capital per worker is positive as you keep increasing one factor. Okay, keeping other constant. So each additional unit of worker is adding less output. Okay, it means that is why Sunop is declining, but it is positive. Okay, yesterday we have done it. I hope that you remember. Okay. So this is the derivation from supply side. Remember this equation. Okay. Now I will be doing from the demand side. Remember this equation. Okay, let me write from top. See, from tomorrow, if you are not able to join by 12:05, okay, then better take rest. Okay, that day. No need to join. Otherwise, you will be not getting anything. Okay, from supply side, output per worker is a function of capital per worker. Okay, where marginal product of capital per worker is positive. As you keep adding double prime, okay, you can use any notation. Okay, as I keep adding one factor, keeping other constant, the marginal product of that factor will decline. That it means that simple thing. Okay, now I am going to look at demand cycle. Okay, demand for goods. Okay, here what I am going to do the derivation. Okay, remember that part. Okay, there is one mistake that most of the students make. Okay, while even in the examination. So remember the notation that I am going to use here. Okay. So now assume that demand for goods consists of consumption demand or consumption expenditure and investment expenditure. Okay. So now assume that demand for goods consists of consumption expenditure and investment expenditure. So I write simply as y equal to c plus i. I have to write in per worker term. Okay. So I write this in per worker term. You write in other line, okay, not in the same line. This is consumption per worker. Okay. Now I want to know what is this consumption per worker. Okay. This is output per worker, I define by small y. Okay. Investment per worker, I write it small i. When I write small i, it means investment per worker. Okay. Now I want to know what is this consumption per worker. Okay. Income, you either consume or save in a two sector model. Okay. And saving by assumption is a proportion of income. In the normal it will be proportion of income. Okay, even they not take assumption, this will be the case. Okay, because consumption will be proportion of income. Okay, so I substitute this value here. Okay, so I write plus c small s y. What is small s here? Okay, yeah, marginal point to say. Okay, remember this part. Only this part I want you to use. Okay, small s is your marginal propensity to save. Okay, don't confuse with this small term. Okay, so your income is this term. Okay, I take this that side. So y will be common. 1 minus s equal to c. Okay, so I divide both sides by m. So consumption per worker is equal to this term. Consumption per worker, I can write this. So I substitute here. Okay. This is consumption per worker, I denote by small c. Okay, remember this. Consumption per worker, I denote by small c. Don't confuse with MPC. Okay. This is consumption per worker, I denote by small c. I write here 1 minus s. S is your propensity to save, marginal propensity to save. Y. Okay, I take on this term this side, so you will be getting S y equal to y from demand side. Okay, now what is this term? Can anyone tell me? This you know, everyone knows. This is investment per worker. What is this term? Just open it. Okay, I give plus 1. If anybody can tell me what is this term, I will add plus 1 to their income. What is this term? No need to submit any homework, just tell me what is this term. Open the term. Okay, just see what is small s, you will be knowing it. Okay, let me do. So saving is some proportion of income. Okay, so MPS is what? S by y is your s. Okay, let me make it simplified. Saving is some proportion of income, I divided by neighbor. Okay, so this is what? Saving per worker, right? Saving per worker is how much? 4.2 save time output per worker. What is this term? Saving per worker, right? Yes or no? This is your MPS. Marginal propensity same times output per worker is what? Saving per worker. Okay? If people just have to put L, you get 1 marks. Okay? So saving per worker equal to investment per worker. For demand side, you get equilibrium. Yes or no? So from supply side you have this one, from demand side you have this one. I substitute the value of y this one here. Okay, I get equilibrium. Everyone agree? Yes, no. This is a saving per worker equal to investment per worker. Okay. This is my output that I required from demand side. If I substitute from supply side, okay, this equation here, okay, in equilibrium, my demand will be equal to supply. Everyone agree? Okay. Okay. So I wrote this part. Okay. Write it down. This thing we are going to use it. If you have any doubt, stop me. Ask me 10 times. I have no issue. Okay. But clarify this thing. What we are doing. And remember, this saving propensity, now it is between 0 and 1. So there are two reading, okay, from Mankiw Macroeconomics. If you have book, then it's okay. I will place it in the website. Okay. Password will be small as sashi1234. Then you will be having option one. You have to click that one. Okay. Then you can access the two chapter. Okay. If I remember, let me check. But remember, small as sashi1234. I think this is the password. Then you can get option one. Click that one, and you will get access to that two chapter. You have to read that two chapter, one in solo mode, okay? Clear this part? Okay. Now, how we will draw the graph of this one? Okay, let me first put it. So, in equilibrium, I can write S of Fk equal I. Okay, this thing I can write it out. Okay? Now, this S is a major perpendicular set that lies between 0 and 1. Okay? So, if you remember the graph, you have to draw a graph properly in a bigger space. Okay? So, this is your production function. This is output per worker is a function of captain per worker. Every time when you write, okay, talk to your son. Here you have output per worker. Here you have captain per worker. Okay, in the beginning you can write this output by labor. You can write capital per worker, capital by labor. Okay, so you are writing the same function, but it will be lower because saving will be set 30%, 0.3. So it will be below this curve. Okay, so this will be S of F. Okay, so what is this distance? This total distance is your output per worker, okay? This is what saving per worker, right? Yes or no? Saving per worker or investment per worker? This distance is saving per worker or investment per worker. I can make it more lower, better. Let me make it lower. Because saving must be 30% or 40%, not more than that. So let me make it much lower. Okay? This is as I put here. This is my output level. Okay. This distance, any distance you can take it. Okay. This is my investment per worker or saving per worker corresponding to this capital per worker. Okay. And this is my consumption per worker. Okay. If my total output is this much, output per worker is this much. This is my consumption per worker. Okay. And this is my saving per worker or investment per worker. Can you hear everyone? This entire distance is my output per worker. Output you either consume or save. So I am looking in per worker term. So this is my saving per worker curve. This distance is my saving per worker. In equilibrium of saving per worker will be equal to investment per worker. That means saving will be equal to investment. Okay. We are just adding per worker term. And remaining part will be your consumption per worker. Okay. This distance is consumption per worker. This is investment per worker. Clear, everyone? Okay, now we are going to look at growth in the capital stock. in the Hadot model and Domo model. Okay. Okay. Let me summarize this part. Then I will look at growth model. I am summarizing the argument. Okay. So Sona has looked at demand and supply side. Okay. For supply side, he has considered the production function. Output is a supply side. Okay. Function of capital and labor. Okay. He has considered production function of homogeneous degree one, homogeneous of degree one. Okay. That exhibits constant interval scale. Okay. If I multiply my input by lambda, my output will increase by lambda. Okay. Remember this. Output will increase by lambda. So in place of this, I directly write y. Okay. Take lambda equal to 1 by n. So I can write my production function in per worker term. So this will be output per worker. I take this one. Output per worker, I write this one, is a function of capital per worker. Okay, and given the assumption, okay, even factor is fixed, okay, marginal product of capital per worker will be positive, okay, as we keep adding one factor, keeping other constant, okay, each worker will be adding next to output. It will add positively, but next to output, okay, so it is denied, okay, and you are having production function of this kind. Y is a function of output per worker is a function of captain per worker. This is captain per worker, this is output per worker. In short, you can remember in this one. Okay. Yes? Because we want to analyze in per worker term. Okay. If you remember, economic growth we define in two ways. One is extensive growth, second is intensive growth. Okay. Lambda we can take anything. Lambda is a term, we increase the input by lambda. Lambda could be anything, right? So we have just taking the thing in per worker term. You can take anything, I am converting into per worker term, okay? Okay. So from demand side, okay? Sona has considered consumption expenditure demand and investment expenditure demand, okay? That means he is also considering capitalist economy, okay? So your income is what? Consumption plus investment. So everything is he has considered in per worker term. Okay. And consumption per worker, okay, we just derive is 1 minus S Y. Okay. So output per worker is equal to 1 minus S Y plus investment per worker. Okay. So I take this side, so I will get this term. What is this? This will be my saving per worker. Why? Because saving is a proportion of income. So saving per worker will be equal to S saving propensity time output per worker. Okay. So this term is what my saving per worker. Okay. Saving per worker. This represents my saving per worker. Saving per worker or per labor, whatever you want to write. Equal to investment per worker. Okay. In equilibrium, this must be equal to this. Okay, so I can substitute this in equilibrium item. In equilibrium. Okay, I am just writing this, okay, write it properly. Okay. In equilibrium. This term will be equal to this is saving per worker in equilibrium equal to investment per worker. Okay. Now we have this graph. This is your production function. Okay. Output per worker is a function of capital per worker. Okay. Write output per worker, capital per worker on which give the notation, then you will draw the saving per worker graph. It will be below this because saving lies between 0 and 1. Okay, we know your production function. Okay, so this will be your saving per worker graph. Okay, this distance represents your saving per worker or investment per worker, this distance represents your consumption per worker, and this total is consumption per worker plus saving per worker. So this represents output per worker. Okay, we have done thing that. Okay, you have to remember this. So make a mind map to remember the thing. Okay. I practice it per worker, okay, every time. Okay. So investment in the Hadot model and Domo model, we have considered in terms of net investment. Okay. Here we will be considering gross investment. Okay. So what is gross investment? What is gross investment? Anyone? What is gross investment? Okay, what is investment? Yeah, increase in the capital stock. Okay, so I talk about gross investment, everybody get confused. What is net investment? Net is gross minus depreciation. Forget about investment. Whenever they give you net, national income accounting, you people have done it. Net is equal gross minus depreciation. Okay, so here whatever we are considering, we are taking gross investment. Okay, then we will be looking at what is happening. Okay, so we will be having a component of depreciation. Okay, which is a constant proportion of your capital stock. Depreciation will be constant proportion of your capital stock. Okay, that I'm going. Remember one thing, when I say constant proportion, how you will draw the graph? Depreciation is constant proportion of your capital stock. This is D term. Say D. So how you will draw the graph? Here you have output per worker, you have capital per worker. Yeah, straight line from the origin. Very good. Okay. Remember the graph of constant proportion? Everyone? We have done technical video, it is in the YouTube also, you can look at it. Okay? So when you have a proportion relationship, it will form the origin straight line. Okay? Very good. And I will be keep adding. Right now I am just putting depreciation. Later on I will be putting population. Okay? And right now I am telling this depreciation. Okay? Later on I will say this is break-even point and more thing I will be adding up. Okay? So first I am looking at growth in capital stock. Okay, growth means addition to the capital stock. Okay, so there are two factors which affect the stock of capital in the economy. Okay, one is investment. Investment increases the capital stock. Okay, second is your depreciation. Depreciation decreases the capital stock. Okay, so there are two factors which affect the capital stock in the economy. One is investment. That increase the capital stock. Second is your depreciation, that decrease the capital stock. Okay, and investment refer to the accumulation of capital stock. Okay, you can say purchase of plant and machinery. Okay, tools and equipment. So when you have investment taking place, capital stock rise in the economy. Okay, and in the Sono model, it assumes that investment is equal to saving. That we have driven. Okay, depreciation refer to the fall in the value of capital stock. Okay. Why it happened? It happened due to V and T of capital stock. Okay? What is depreciation? Depreciation refers to the form in value of the capital stock. Okay? Due to V and T of the capital stock with the passage of time. Clear? Is it clear? Okay. With depreciation, just write 119. Okay? So now assume that. Capital stock depreciate at a constant rate delta. So now assume that capital stock depreciate at a constant rate delta. Okay. Therefore, depreciation just I did is just some proportion of your capital stock. Okay. Some proportion of your capital stock. Clear? And you can draw the graph of depreciation here. This is my depreciation, I'm writing here depreciation. Okay. You can write in per worker term also, as similar thing. So this is your delta small k. Okay, just divide with neighbor. Even. Depreciation, so now assume that capital stock is a constant proportion. Capital stock depreciate at a constant rate delta. Capital stock. Depreciate at a constant rate delta. Okay? I said that delta is my depreciation of the capital stock. And my capital stock depreciate at a constant rate delta. Capital stock, whatever capital stock I have, has been depreciated at a constant rate delta. Okay, let me give you example. So delta is 0.1, 10%. Okay, so if economy has capital stock of 120, if depreciation rate is 10%, 0.1, then how much capital stock will depreciate? 0.1 into 120. That means 12 unit of capital stock will depreciate every year. Okay. So my capital stock will depreciate at a constant rate delta. That is what I'm saying. So we write depreciation here, and here write capital per worker. So delta capital per worker. Okay. Clear everyone? Okay. So depreciation is just constant proportion of capital stock. So remember this part. Now you have to look at this term. So what is my gross investment? KT plus 1 minus KT. Net investment, how much we are adding to the capital stock, right? This is my net investment, okay? Plus depreciation, delta KT. Okay, this is clear. Okay, I am looking at growth in capital stock. By formula, it will be delta K by K. Okay, so this is in absolute term, you can convert into per worker. Okay, so this is investment per worker. This is capital per worker in period T plus 1. This is capital per worker in period T. This is capital per worker in period T. Depreciation rate is constant, so it will remain the same. Okay? So I can write this as investment per worker equal to capital stock. Let me write delta K directly, this term. Delta is small. Okay? Change in capital stock plus delta is small. Clear? This change is capital stock plus delta K. Okay. Don't get confused with these two. This is change, just a change in capital stock. Okay? Okay. So my change in capital stock per worker will be equal to investment per worker minus depreciation times capital per worker. Okay? Change in capital stock per worker equal to investment per worker minus depreciation times capital stock per worker. Is it clear? So what investment does? Investment increase the capital stock, right? And depreciation reduce the capital stock. Okay? So one is increasing the capital stock and other is reducing the capital stock. That will give me my change in capital stock. Okay? Clear? You just remember this part. Okay? I have written gross investment equal to your net investment addition to capital stock plus depreciation. Okay? So you have written in gross investment term. Then I want to look at, because I am looking at growth in capital stock. Okay? So I look at delta K. So I convert it into per worker term. Okay? So when I am looking at capital per worker, how much is the change in capital per worker? It will be the investment per worker minus depreciation per worker. Okay? Logically, if you look at what investment is doing, I am just not saying per worker. Okay? Understand this. Investment increase the capital stock, depreciation reduce the capital stock. Okay? So whatever is coming up will be your addition to capital stock. Okay? So change in capital stock, just write in simple verb. Just for your understanding, change in capital stock equal investment minus depreciation. For the time being, on the side just write it out. Okay? And remember that investment add to the capital stock and depreciation reduce to the capital stock. Okay? Now, in place of I, what can I write? In equilibrium, what we have written? Yeah, what is I? Investment per worker must be equal to saving per worker, right? Therefore, change in capital stock will be equal to saving for work, I write like this. In equilibrium, I will write like this. Right? This represent my saving per work in equilibrium. Clear? Everyone? I just make short demand side and supply side and make it in equilibrium. Okay, let me put it again. So from supply side, you have equation. Output is a function of, output per worker is a function of capital per worker. Demand side, remember the equation, okay, that we have derived, okay? What we have derived? Saving per worker equal to investment per worker. In this place, I have substituted this term in equilibrium. So in equilibrium, as f of k, this is saving per worker in equilibrium must be equal to investment per worker, right? So in place for investment per worker, I am writing this term. Can you everyone? Okay, minus delta. Okay, so you have growth in capital and stock. I can divide by small k also. No need to do that. You understand? Okay. So my growth in capital and stock. Okay, is determined by my investment per worker and depreciation per worker. Okay, and there are three possibility. Every time I do three possibility. Okay, here also I can do three possibility. This can be greater than equal to less than 0. Okay? So at a steady state, your capital stock must be growing at a constant rate. Everyone agree? At a steady state, your capital stock must be growing at a constant rate. Yes or no? Okay? So at a steady state, okay, my change in capital stock must be equal to 0. Right? Producer is in equilibrium when at a steady state capital stock is not changing. Right? This thing is clear. When you keep adding to your capital stock, okay, that means every time there is a new capital stock coming up. Will you be in a steady state? When this term is positive, delta k is positive, will you be in a steady state? Every time there is an addition to capital stock? No, right? Why? Because at steady state, okay, on the paper must be growing at a constant rate. Capital stock must be growing at a constant rate. Okay? At a steady state, level of capital is such that, okay, capital stock is not changing, you can say that. At a steady state, our level of capital stock is such that our level of capital stock is not changing. Okay? Producer is in equilibrium, okay, at that level of capital stock. That means producer don't want to change the capital stock that they have. Okay. So, is it clear or no? See, at a steady state level of capital stock, okay, capital stock will not change. Okay. Producer is in equilibrium, that means that level of capital stock, producer are happy to be that level of capital stock. Okay? Economy is at a constant rate. Yeah, at a constant rate. Okay? Yeah. But if capital stock is keep growing, can we achieve a steady state? What by steady? On the variable must be growing at a constant rate. That constant rate must be zero, can be zero also. Right? This is capital per worker term. This is growth rate in capital per worker is zero. That means capital per worker is growing at a constant rate. That means my population is growing, capital is also growing at the same rate. Okay? And so there is nothing net. producer is content with what they are doing. It will be clear, it will be getting clear. Okay. So at steady state, okay, level of capital stock is such that, okay, capital stock is not changing. For the time being, just understand this. I will clarify. I will do the mathematics part little bit. That will be more clear. Okay. Okay. So which means that your investment per worker must be equal to depreciation per worker, right? So S of F care must be equal to delta care. Okay. So investment per worker must be equal to depreciation per worker. Okay. So let me depict this in graph. Okay. So what I am doing today is a beginning point. Okay. Later on when I will add on. I will clarify in total output term also, because without mathematics it will be little bit, not much, okay, just little bit. I will do the logarithm part again, okay, derivation part that I have done, so that you can get phone over there. Okay, so here I write capital per worker, here I write output per worker. Okay, this is your production function in per worker term. Always interpret the way I am interpreting. Okay. Then you will draw saving per worker graph. Okay, remember one thing. Okay, before I am drawing graph, many students are making mistake. They are bending it. If you bend in the examination, you are getting zero. Okay, so don't bend your graph. In some of the book they bend. Students saw me last year. Say it bend in the book. Last lecture I have done only to show that you will not bend your graph. Okay. You will end your graph here, okay, at this point. Okay, many students draw like this. You will not draw like this. Okay, is it clear to everyone? Okay, last time I have to take means I have to make everyone draw in the class. I have taken 3-4 lectures only to draw this graph. Okay, so in the examination, if you are not drawing it properly, sir. You draw like this. This graph cannot be drawn like this. Is it going straight now? One student drawing like this, and this is going like this. So it is going straight. Why are you making this straight? Okay. So practice it. Okay. So the graph is very important, and the moment you bend it, okay, your 2-3 marks is cut here. Okay. If I am checking the paper, that is the case. Okay. So this is your saving per worker. And I am going to draw my depreciation line. This is delta Q. Okay. So this point. Okay. What saving per worker or investment per worker equal to depreciation per worker. That means my change in capital stock per worker is zero. And that is my steady state. Okay. I did not buy K star. Then what will be my output per worker? What will be my output per worker? Don't do from here. Okay. This give me saving per worker, investment per worker. Why this is steady state? It will be clear now. Okay. I am going to discuss these two cases. Greater than less than zero case, then it will be clear. Okay. No need to worry. When you are going to depict output per worker, this is the graph for that one. Okay. 2-3 students have done from here. In spite of doing 10 times in the class, this mistake is done. Okay. So when you have to depict output per worker, you will depict from here, Y star. Okay? Clear? So at point E, okay, investment per worker equal to depreciation per worker. Okay? That will give me my steady state level of capital stock. Write down. At point E. Okay? Investment per worker, this line, investment per worker, okay, investment per worker equal to depreciation per worker, okay, that will give me my steady state level of capital stock. The level of output corresponding to my level of steady state level of capital stock is called steady state level of output. Steady state level of output. In a steady state level, I am repeating one more time. Okay. At point A, investment per worker equal to depreciation per worker. Look at this. This black 9 is investment per worker 9, right? Equal to my depreciation per worker. Okay? At point E, investment per worker equal to depreciation per worker. That will give me my steady state level of capital stock cash down. Okay? Clear? The level of output by star, you can say, the level of output corresponding to my steady state level of capital stock, okay, is my steady state level of output. Okay, the level of output by star corresponding to my steady state level of capital stock, we can just say corresponding to my steady state level of capital stock per worker, okay, the output level that we have is my steady state level of output per worker. On which I per work, okay? Sometime I don't speak. So, the steady state level of capital stock per worker, okay, is known as nominal equilibrium of the economy. Okay? Why it is nominal equilibrium of the economy? Because if I have this sign, let me put it here. This term I put equal to 0, I get this. Okay, if I have this possibility, any of these two possibility greater than equal to 0, okay, economy will have tendency to move toward K star. That is why it is called steady state level of capital stock. Okay, so that is what I am going to show now. Okay, why K star is my steady state level of capital stock, okay, and why change in capital stock, okay, equal to 0, I am considering there are three possibility. Okay, steady state level of capital stock is that capital stock where your capital stock is not changing. Okay, that means producer don't have incentive to change the capital stock. Okay, let's look at this point. Say K1. Okay, at K1, what you have? Just look at the graph. At K1, what you have? You are correct to some extent. Anyone want to elaborate more? This is what? This point belongs to investment. Yeah. Good. Look at this graph. Yeah. Look at this graph. Yeah. Asset K 9. This point corresponds to my asset K 9. Investment per worker 9, this is my depreciation per worker 9, right? So I am looking at a case where this condition hold. Okay, let me write properly. So growth in capital stock I am looking at. Change in capital stock per worker is saving per worker in equilibrium minus depreciation per worker, and depreciation is constant. So we have the three possibility. Okay. So first possibility, I say that change in capital stock per worker is 0. Yes. Okay. When change in capital stock per worker is 0, you have a steady state. Okay. First possibility, I am saying that this is saving per worker in equilibrium or investment per worker minus depreciation per worker is positive. Okay, so my investment schedule is greater than my investment depreciation schedule. So investment greater than depreciation. I am writing in simple word. At K1, at point K1, investment is greater than depreciation. Right? So when investment is greater than depreciation, next period capital stock will increase. Yes or no? In the short term, capital stock generates income that we have done in the Hadot model. In the long run, it adds to productive capacity. Okay? So when investment is greater than depreciation, in the next period, capital stock will increase. Okay? So I move towards K star. Okay? Now look at here. Depreciation is more than investment. Okay, take this to be K2. Okay, at K2, this is for K1. At K2, investment is less than depreciation. That means depreciation per capital per worker is greater than investment per worker. I'm not saying, I'm just keeping it simple. Depreciation is more than investment. That means from next period onward, capital stock will decrease. Okay, in here everyone. Okay, that is why this K star, okay, is called steady state nominal equilibrium. In here, producer has no incentive to change the capital stock. Okay, that means that if capital stock is at steady state K star, okay, given your investment per worker, your production function, okay. So if your capital stock is at K star, at steady state, then it will stay there forever, okay. Unless there is a change in saving rate, okay, or there is a change in depreciation rate, that means decline in the depreciation rate or increase in the depreciation rate for the time. Clear? Depreciation is constant. I am saying that if there is a change in depreciation rate, when we are comparing two economy, okay, that we will do later on. I am saying that if there is a change in depreciation rate, unless and until there is change in saving rate and depreciation rate, okay, this steady state capital stock will remain same forever. Okay, clear everyone? Okay, so here what we have looked at impact of saving at steady state, keeping population constant. We have not introduced population, okay, and technological progress given. Okay, so this growth process that I have shown you just now, this is steady state capital stock. Okay, this I just look at the impact of saving at a steady state, keeping population constant. That means its growth rate I have taken to be zero, and technical progress to be given. Okay, can you everyone? Okay, so slowly, I will start to add. Population growth also term, it will be added to your this line. Right now I am saying this to be depreciation line. Okay, I am going to keep changing the definition of this line. Okay, so keep in track what I am saying. In the examination question will be very easy. Okay, only thing you have to understand what they are saying. Okay, so at a steady state, okay, growth in capital stock will be zero. Okay, why? If change in capital stock is greater than zero, okay, that means investment is more than depreciation. In the next period, capital stock will increase. If depreciation is more than investment, capital stock will decrease. So you will ultimately achieve K star, and economy will stay here forever. Okay, so K star represents my steady state capital stock, and that I derive from my growth in capital stock equation. Okay, so let me again summarize the thing. What we have done today. So whenever you are doing this thing, okay, remember what we are saying. Okay, so in the Sono model, okay, or you can say New Keynesian growth model, it is designed to show how growth in capital stock, labor force, and technology determine the growth in output. He has considered intensive form of growth. That means in per worker term, okay. So per worker term, that means output per worker, you can say. Output per worker, this is also called labor productivity. Okay. Or you can say this to be in terms of output per capita. Okay. This we use also output per capita. And this we use to determine standard only. So what first we have done, we have to like any economic model, okay? In the SONO model, we look at the supply side, we look at the demand side. From supply side, we use the production function. Taken a production function is homogeneous of degree one. That means production function exhibits constant return to scale, okay? So when we double the input, my output will double. So lambda I have taken 1 by n. Lambda you can take any value, I have taken 1 by n in order to convert into per capita term, okay? So output per worker, okay, is a function of capital per worker from supply side, okay? And my margin product of capital per worker is positive, okay? And as I keep adding one factor, keeping other constant, it is adding less to output. It is adding positively, but less to output, okay? So it is declining. This is from a production side. From demand side, SONO has considered two sector, consumption expenditure, household has consumption expenditure, firm has investment expenditure. So your income is consumption plus investment. We have converted it into per worker term, okay? Then we get the term saving per worker, okay? Remember that derivation part, keep in mind this is saving per worker. This is margin profit to save times output per worker give me saving per worker, okay, equal to investment per worker in equilibrium. Okay, demand must be equal to supply. So I substitute this term here. So I have saving per worker or investment per worker, saving per worker in equilibrium must be equal to investment per worker. Okay, this graph, if you remember, we have drawn like this, increasing and decreasing rate. Okay. Increasing and decreasing rate. So I write output per worker here, capital per worker here, okay, and this is your output per worker graph. Okay, now I want to draw this graph, okay, saving per worker graph. It will be below this because saving lies between 0 and 1. Okay, after that I have determined growth in capital stock, growth in capital stock. Okay, I have done in discrete form because this is undergraduate course, okay, and mathematically we can do it also, but just keep things simple, then you people can check it out. Delta K by K give me growth in capital stock in discrete form, okay. So I am just using delta K for the time being. So we have determined my growth in capital stock per worker, okay, always writing in small term, okay, remember this part. Capital stock per worker equal to saving per worker in equilibrium, which is equal to investment per worker. Look at this one, okay, minus depreciation per worker, okay. This is constant and depreciation rate also lies between 0 and 1, okay. So this is what my investment. Investment increases the capital stock, depreciation reduces the capital stock. That will give me my change in capital stock per worker. Okay, simple thing. Investment increases the capital stock, depreciation, net net depreciation. Depreciation reduces the capital stock. So this two things will give me change in capital stock per worker. Okay. I always say that there are three possibilities, greater than equal to less than zero. Okay. So I say that at a steady state, okay, producer will be content with what they are producing when they change in capital stock is zero. Okay. Change in capital stock per worker is zero. This I have shown with the graph. This is output per worker. I am drawing output per worker graph because I want to show at a steady state what will be my output level. Okay, that is the reason why I am drawing. If in the examination they don't ask you to show that thing, no need to draw this graph. Okay, this is, see how I am drawing the graph. Okay, don't bend it, don't make it rising. Okay, I have spent almost 1.5 lecture in this one. Okay, so this is output per worker graph. This is your saving or investment per worker. Make it down. So it will be 30% or 40% of your, okay. This is your saving per worker graph, okay. And I am drawing my depreciation, which is a constant proportion of your capital stock graph, okay. So here I write output per worker, here I write capital per worker, okay. This term here will be K star, okay. Steady state level of capital stock or nominal equilibrium level of capital stock, okay. With no population growth, with no population growth, and given technical progress, okay. So if my saving rate is S, given the depreciation rate, this K star is my steady state level of capital stock. Economy will remain here forever. Why? Because if your investment per worker you can add it. If your my investment is more than depreciation, okay, next period more capital stock will be added. I will rescale the. Okay. If my depreciation is more than investment, okay, next period capital stock will move forward. So economy will have tendency to move towards this K star. Okay. So K star is my steady state level of capital stock. Okay. Producer is in equilibrium at this level of capital stock. Okay. Given the saving rate and depreciation rate, at this level of capital stock, Y star is my steady state level of output. Okay. So I stop here. Tomorrow we will do one numerical related to this. Okay. It will be simple one. Okay. I will give the simple one.